Hello friends, this is Adyan and Tiwari and this is the lecture number 3 on the power system. So we have covered the transmission line parameter, so ABCD parameter classification of transmission line. So we'll cover. Now next we'll see the power relation for the transmission line. Okay, so this is suppose generator, any generator, and this side voltage has Vs angle delta and receiving end voltage Vr angle 0. So we have taken reference as receiving end. And this transmission line has parameter ABCD parameter is ABCD. So by saying ABCD, this transmission line can be any type, either short line or medium line. Okay. So suppose sending end voltage as VS magnitude and angle as delta. VR receiving end voltage as VR magnitude angle 0. A has magnitude A angle alpha. B has B magnitude and angle beta. C has C magnitude gamma delta and D has D magnitude and as angle alpha, as A equals to D in generally cases. Okay, so now we are first deriving receiving and power. Receiving and power. So receiving and power, that is active power and reactive power both. So we know Vs equals to AVR plus BIR. If we put in phasor form, first calculate IR. So what is IR? If you see VS, AVR can be goes to left hand side. So VS minus AVR and again divide by B, that is VS by B minus AVR by B. So this is IR in phasor form. So this is number equation 1. So if you put the phasor value, that is Vs as Vs angle delta and B has B magnitude and angle as beta minus A has A magnitude alpha and Vr magnitude angle 0 by B has magnitude beta B and angle as beta. Okay, so this is Vs by B angle as delta minus beta minus AVR by B as angle as alpha minus beta. So this is IR. So if you want to calculate the complex power across receiving end side, that is SR, you need to apply the VR into IR conjugate. Okay, so why conjugate, we have covered in lecture number 1. So VR into IR conjugate, so that is VR has magnitude as VR and angle as 0 and IR is Vs by B angle of delta minus beta minus AVR by B and angle is alpha minus beta and this is all conjugated. Conjugate means angle is minus become plus and plus become minus, that is this delta minus beta is comes to beta minus delta and this alpha minus beta become beta minus alpha. So if you multiply this VR also, then you will get Vs VR by B and angle it has 0, that means only beta minus delta minus A VR square by B then beta minus alpha. So this is the receiving end power. If you want the PR, that is active receiving end power, then generally put here cos angle and here cos angle, and if you want the reactive power, receiving end reactive power, then apply sine, then you will get the PR and QR. Then if you apply cos, that is PR becomes Vs VR by B into, there was angle of beta minus delta, that is cos of beta minus delta minus, this is AVR square by B, then cos of beta minus alpha. This is the receiving end power, active power, and QR. In place of cos, just put sine, Vs VR by B sine of beta minus delta minus AVR square by B sine of beta minus alpha. So this is the receiving end active power and reactive power. Okay, now next we want to calculate the sending end power, that is sending, and power. The sending and power, that is equals to SS, is sending and voltage and sending and current conjugate. So we know the sending and current, IS equals to CVR plus DIR. Okay, so in place of IR we have calculated IR in previous case. So IR we have calculated VS by B magnitude and angle is delta minus beta minus AVR by B and angle is alpha minus beta. So we have calculated IR. So put this IR here. So this equation become C magnitude and it has alpha gamma VR magnitude 0 plus D has magnitude D, angle as alpha. So put IR value, this become VS by B, angle as delta minus beta minus AVR by B, angle as alpha minus beta. Now next VR C, this VR as C, angle gamma plus D multiplied with both the term, that is VS D by B, and the angle become delta minus beta plus alpha, then minus AD by B alpha minus beta plus alpha. Okay, so this term has VR and here also a VR is there. Okay, so this term we can take common VR, so it become C angle gamma minus AD by B. Okay, I'm taking A and to D, that is angle of A plus angle of D, and beta angle is for B, plus VS D by B delta minus beta plus alpha. Again VR, this B is multiplied with C, that is B angle beta into C angle gamma minus AD alpha plus alpha, sorry, alpha plus alpha for A and D, that is B and beta. Again plus VS D by B angle of delta minus beta plus alpha. Then if you see this B into C in phasor form and A into D, that is we can write it here AD minus BC equals to 1, we know. Okay, so AD minus BC is 1, that is here BC minus AD equals to minus 1. So if you put this term we are taking first, VS D by B delta minus beta plus alpha and minus VR by B angle beta, because this term become minus 1. Okay, so this VR by V into beta, so this is the sending end current. Okay, so IS calculated is DVS by B into angle of delta minus beta plus alpha plus, sorry, it is minus VR by B and angle of minus beta, because beta is initially is in the denominator, so it becomes minus beta. So we want to calculate the sending and power, that is equals to VS into IS conjugate. So VS is VS angle delta, and IS we have DVS by B, and we are directly using conjugating, that is plus become minus and minus become plus, that is beta minus delta minus alpha minus VR by B, and minus beta becomes plus beta. Then again if you multiply VS in both the term, it will become dvs square by b, and delta, and here in minus delta, so it cancel the delta, that is beta minus alpha minus vs and vr, that is vs vr by b beta plus delta. So this is the sending end complex power. So if you want to calculate the active power sending end, that is use the cos term with the angle, that is dvs square by b cos of beta minus alpha minus vs vr by b cos of beta plus delta, and qs is use sine term in place of cos, then dvs square by b sine of beta minus alpha minus vs vr by b sine of beta plus delta. So this is total sending end power, active power and reactive power, and we have calculated the receiving end power pr and qr. So first write the pr and qr. Pr and qr, so pr was vs vr by b cos of beta minus delta minus avr square by b cos of beta minus alpha, and qr was vs vr by b sine of beta minus delta minus avr square by b sine of beta minus alpha. So this is the receiving and active power and reactive power, and the above is the active power and reactive power for the sending end part. So you need to remember both the formulas. Is this, if you want to remember one formula, if you remember this formula PR, that is Vs Vr by B into cos of beta minus delta minus AVR square by B into cos of beta minus alpha, then you can remember QR also. And if you want to find the difference between PR and QR formula, then if you see this Vs Vr by B in sending end part come to this part, and this beta minus delta comes as beta plus delta, and this dvs square by b, this avr square by b looks common because d and e a are equal, and this we are using ps, that's why it is sending end voltage, and we are calculating pr, that's why it is receiving end voltage, and this is beta minus alpha, this is beta minus alpha. So this way you can remember the formula. Okay, so this is, this formula must remember, because the in this is formula is applicable to all type of transmission line, either it is short line, medium line or long line, because for transmission line we can calculate ABCD by using the formulas we have studied. Okay, so if you can calculate the ABCD, and we all know the VS voltage of line, then you can calculate PS, QS, PR and QR. Okay, now see the power for short transmission line. Okay, we have derived the power for the common line, that is either it is short line, medium line or long line. Now see, we'll see the power for the short transmission line. For the short transmission line, we have ABCD parameter as 1Z01, 1Z, and in transmission line Z equals to R plus J XL in short transmission line. Okay, but if suppose generally in short transmission line R is much smaller than XL, so we can neglect here R, so in place of Z we can write it as JXL, and C is 0, D is 1 in short transmission line. That means A equals to 1 angle 0, B equals to XL angle 90, C equals to 0, and D equals to 1 angle 0. So now we are calculating the power, first receiving end power for the short transmission line. Receiving end power. So PR was VS VR by B cos of beta minus delta minus AVR square by B cos of beta minus alpha. So VS VR is common for both VS VR, and in place of B magnitude is now XL, so in place of B put XL. Cos of beta minus delta, so cos beta is 90 degree and delta is delta because we are not changing the voltage, that is VS angle is delta and VR angle is 0, minus A is 1 and VR is VR square. Again, in place of B, we put XL. Cos of beta is 90 degree, alpha is 0 degree. Because alpha here A with angle A is 0. So if you see, cos of 90 minus delta is sine delta. That is VS VR by XL sine of delta. And this is cos 90. Cos 90 is what? 0. So this PR comes at VS VR by XL into sine delta. Okay. Now when next we'll calculate QR, that is VS VR by B. In place of, I'm directly writing here, in place of B, it is XL and it is sine beta minus delta. Beta we have 90 and delta is delta, minus A is 1, VR is square, and B is XL, sine of 90 degree minus 0. So what happened? VS VR by XL, VS VR by XL, and sine of 90 minus delta is cos delta, minus VR square by XL, and sine 90 is 1. So this is the QR for the short transmission line. Okay, so we have calculated PR and QR for the short transmission. Now next we'll see the QS and PS for the short transmission line. Next we are calculating PS. PS we know, general formula, dVS square by B into cos of beta minus alpha minus VS VR by B into cos of beta plus delta. So D we have 1 and VS is VS square by B is XL. Cos of beta we have 90 degree and alpha is 0, minus VS VR, B as XL, cos of 90 because beta is 90 degree and plus delta. So VS square by XL, first term is VS square by XL, that is cos 90 is 0, multiplied is 0, minus VS VR by XL, and cos of 90 plus delta come as minus sine of delta. That means this equation PS is gives them by VS VR by XL sine of delta, and this is equal to PR, because PR we have calculated same, the formula comes same, VS VR by XL into sine of delta. Now we are calculating QS. In place of cos, if you put sine, then it is formula for QS. So directly I am using the formula. In place of D, put 1 and VS is square, B is XL, sine of 90 minus 0, minus VS VR by B. In place of B, it is XL, and that is sine beta is 90 and it is delta. So this formula comes as sine 90 is 1, VS square by XL, minus VS VR by XL into cos of delta, because sine of 90 plus delta is cos of delta. So this formula gives the QS. Okay, so but if you remember the QR formula, the formula is same, just it is opposite. That is, the initially it was VS VR by XL cos delta minus VR square. Sorry, this is not minus QR. Okay, so suppose in short transmission line, VS equals to VR. If magnitude of VS and VR are equal, then what happened? QS to QS, QS become, in place of VS, we can write it as VR. That is VR square by XL minus VS VR multiplied is VR square by XL, and it is cos of delta. Okay, and if you see the QR, QR will be VS VR by XL cos of delta minus VR square by XL. Okay, so you put VS equals to VR in this equation, then you will get QR is VR square by XL cos of delta minus VR square by XL. So if you see both formula are equal but opposite in sign, that is it is Q minus QS. So QR equals to minus QS in case of short transmission line, for the voltage levels are equal. That is, if VS equals to VR magnitude, then the receiving end are both are in opposite direction. Now we'll do the analysis. When voltage levels are equal, that is VS equals to VR, then our QR comes as minus QS. So what does it means? Okay, so here VS angle delta, that is equals to VR angle delta, and this part angle is VR angle 0. Okay, so in place of VS equals to VR, if you see the formula for PR, that is equals to PS, then it gives the VR square by XL into sine of delta. That is, both power, active power comes as positive. That means this is the sending end power direction and this is the direction for the receiving end power. As there is no resistance in the path of the power flow, that means there is no power loss. That's why the sending end power and receiving end power are equal and the direction is same. But if you see the QR and QS are equal, that is, suppose QS going outward from the generator, that is in this direction, so QR comes as minus QS. That is, the direction for QR is opposite to the load. Okay, so what does it means? That means if voltage levels are equal, see this is voltage equal, then there is no reactive power flow from this bus to this bus. Why? So this reactive power, where this reactive power goes, okay, so we know inductor or capacitor only consume reactive power. Okay, so when you supply some power, reactive power always consumes some reactive power. So QS is supplying by generator to the inductor, but this QS is not sufficient to not sufficient for the inductor. That's why QR coming from load and giving to the inductor. This reactive power QS is not going to the R receiving end bus side, and QR is not going to the sending end side. Okay, so suppose we are taking some example, this inductor wants some 10 per unit reactive power, okay, and we are sending 8 per unit reactive power from this direction. So not this is 5 per unit, because the magnitude is same, QS and QR, that's why we are considering 5 per unit, and the QR also is 5 per unit. So that this 5 per unit consumed by inductor and this 5 per unit also is consumed by inductor. That means in this, from this 5 per unit, there is no reactive power flow from this side to receiving end side. Okay, that means for the flow of reactive power, there is only voltage magnitude difference. If V1 is greater than V2 magnitude, then reactive power flow from V1 to V2, that means higher voltage to lower voltage level. But active power flow from higher angle to lower angle, that is this angle, if it has higher angle, that is delta has some positive value and this has zero angle, that means active power always flow from higher angle to lower angle. That's why if you see the PS direction and PR direction are same, because this angle has delta and this is zero, and PS voltage magnitude are equal. That's why there is no power flow from this bus to this bus as reactive power. So remember this things, that is active power flow always due to the angle difference and reactive power always flow due to the voltage magnitude difference. Okay, so this is all about the lecture number 3. So for more updates, subscribe our channel Gatematic, and we'll update more the videos. Okay, so thank you.